join our gathering song this morning. You are welcome here, wherever you're going to, wherever you're coming from, you are welcome here. You are welcome here, wherever you're going to, wherever you're coming from, you are welcome here, 'cause it's a house of love, a house of hope and dreams. It's a house of love, and you are welcome here. Yes, it's a house of love, a house of hope and dreams. It's a house of love, and you are welcome here. And now in Spanish. Bienvenido aquí, doquiera que vayas tú, doquiera que vengas hoy. Bienvenido aquí, bienvenido aquí, doquiera que vayas tú, doquiera que vengas hoy. Bienvenido aquí a este lugar de amor, de sueños e ilusión. A este lugar de amor, bienvenido aquí. Si es un lugar de amor, de sueños e ilusión, es un lugar de amor.
Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to Chalice Unitarian Universalist Congregation. We are a community of diverse beliefs and experiences, nurturing the liberal religious spirit and united by our desire to grow in love and in service. Whoever you are, whomever you love, whatever your life's journey, you are welcome here. Whether you gather with us every Sunday, once or twice a year, or are with us this morning for the first time, we are glad you are here. I'm June Bailey, your worship associate today. Our service is led by our minister, Reverend Sharon Wylie. Our worship musician this morning is Tim McKnight, and our song leader is Jeff Hayes. Our tech team is Sarah Komnick and Dean Godet, and our greeter is Richard Quartz. Welcome to our Sunday worship service. Welcome to those of you here in the chapel, and welcome to those of you watching the service live using Zoom. We welcome children in our community and here in our worship. Please talk with our Director of Family Ministries, Kathleen Swift, to learn more about programs for children. Child care for our youngest children is always available during services. Today is our monthly all-church worship service, when we worship together in ritual and story, moving our bodies and celebrating the joys of our diverse community. This May Day service is our annual celebration of the beauty and blessings of loving with our whole hearts. For those of us here in the chapel, you will notice that we have the windows open. This is to ensure good air circulation in the room. There are also 4 air purifiers in the room. Please feel free to leave the chapel if you are uncomfortable for any reason. You will be able to hear what is happening inside while you are outside in the courtyard. We are always delighted to see newcomers joining us in worship. As a newcomer, you might be interested in the groups and activities we offer. A good way to get information is through our email newsletter and e-news calendar. Online newcomers will receive an email invitation to join our email list after the service. In-person newcomers, if you haven't already given us your email address when you signed in, please share it before you leave. Our weekly email is the best way to get information about the many groups and activities we offer here at Chalice. Now, let's take a breath together. Thank you.
We begin our service by acknowledging that wherever each of us is watching, if we are in what is now called the United States, then we are on land stolen from indigenous peoples. Our congregational home in what is now called Escondido is on land that is part of the traditional territories of the 12 bands of the Kumeyaay Nation and the 7 bands of the Payamkishum, also called Luiseno. Land that is sacred to us now was stolen from people for whom that land was and is still sacred. In recognition that we are the beneficiaries of a history of colonization, we have made financial donations in the past year to 3 local indigenous-led organizations, California Indian Legal Services and Indigenous Centers at SDSU and at CSU San Marcos. It is our hope at Chalice to find our way to right relationship with local tribes.
We begin our service by lighting our chalice, the symbol of our Unitarian Universalist faith. The flaming chalice was first used during World War II by the Unitarian Service Committee as a symbol of life-saving refuge for people fleeing persecution in Europe. In honor of our multi-generational community, we invite everyone here with a birthday this month to come forward as you are willing and able so that we may sing a happy birthday song to you.
We have April in the room.
Which month are we?
April. Oh, yes, April. I'd like to invite our Director of Family Ministries, Kathleen Swift, to join me up front in leading our affirmation. So even if you're a little shy from what happened, you can see me? Okay, here we go. We are Unitarian Universalists, people of open minds, loving hearts, and helping hands. Thank you. Thank you.
words of our call to worship this morning come from Seth Carrier Ladd. Wind that whispers through the willow trees, sun that sustains us, water that washes over the willing earth and weathered stones, a smile shared and savored, a child's squeal of delight as she dances in the daisies and daffodils, the quiet joy of gathered community. This is the spirit of life and love that we call forth now into this gathering. May this spirit infuse our hearts, fill our souls, and carry us forward like a wave on the ocean as we enter now into the sacred time and space. Come, let us worship together. Please rise and
I don't know if we want to rise. You decide. We're going to sing My Roots Go Down. I don't know when we sang that last together, and so I don't know how many of you know it. Are there people who feels like they know My Roots Go Down? Okay, a few people. So this is a kind of song, if you listen to it, the words will be up there, but you'll get the hang of it, and I'll cue you. So I'm going to sing the first verse, and I'm going to sing it twice. We will get it up there.
Yeah.
Sure. You can listen to it, and the words will come up. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down. Down to the earth, my roots go down. Down to the earth, my roots go down. Let's do that again. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down. We'll try the next one. I am a pine tree on a mountainside. I am a pine tree on a mountainside. I am a pine tree on a mountainside. My roots go down. My roots again. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down. I'm a wildflower. I am a wildflower reaching for the sun. I am a wildflower reaching for the sun. I am a wildflower reaching for the sun. My roots go down. My roots again. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down, down to the earth. Stomp with me. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down. Let's do pine tree again. I am a pine tree on a mountainside. I am a pine tree on a mountainside. I am a pine tree on a mountainside. My roots go down. Last time, roots. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down, down to the earth. My roots go down. Down to the earth, my roots go down. Thank you for singing with me.
Whenever we gather together, there will be those among us who are joyful with happy news, as well as those who are grieving or in distress. Our challenge at any gathering is how to honor joy and sorrow together. At this time, we invite anyone with a joy or sorrow here in the chapel to come forward and light a candle at our altar. Parents, please assist your children who would like to light a candle. Our online congregants are welcome to share joys and sorrows with each other in the chat box, and also to light a candle of joy or sorrow in your own space. And Reverend Sharon will lead us in singing.
I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace.
like a river. I've got peace like a river in my soul.
Joy like a fountain.
I've got joy like a fountain. I've got joy like a fountain. I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. I've got joy like a fountain. I've got joy like a fountain. I've got joy like a fountain in my soul.
Tears like the raindrops.
I've got tears. Tears like raindrops in my soul. I've got tears like the raindrops. I've got tears. Like the raindrops, I've got tears like the raindrops in my soul.
Love like an ocean.
I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean in my soul. I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean in my soul.
Strength like a mountain.
I've got strength like a mountain. I've got strength like a mountain. I've got strength like a mountain in my soul. I've got strength like a mountain. I've got strength like a mountain. I've got strength like a mountain in my soul.
Peace like a river.
I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river in my soul.
And now I'd like to invite anyone who'd like to come up, but maybe especially children, to sit up front for the story.
Today's story is called Guess Who My Favorite Person Is. It was written by Bird Baylor and illustrated by Robert Andrew Parker. I happened to be in an alfalfa field, barefoot, sort of lying down, watching ladybugs climb yellow flowers, when I saw this little farm kid who was also barefoot, sort of lying down, watching ladybugs climb yellow flowers, and helping them up again when they fell off. "Want to see my favorite one?" she called to me. So I went over to where she was. She pointed to a bug. To tell the truth, I couldn't see much difference between that one and about a million others. I was going back to my own part of the field when she said, "Now choose your favorite one." It wasn't easy because I hadn't ever practiced choosing ladybugs, but I finally did. She looked surprised. "I can't believe you like that one. I passed her up about 2 days ago. But that's your business." For a while, we didn't talk at all. I stretched out and closed my eyes and just let the alfalfa be taller than I was. But she said, "What's your favorite thing, sleeping or being awake?" "Awake," I said. "Then wake up and we can play the tell what your favorite thing is game." "I think we are already playing it," I said. She said, "We are, and it's my turn. My favorite turn is first." So I said, go ahead. She said, tell your favorite color. I said, blue. But she said, see, you've already done it wrong. In this game, you can't just say it's blue. You have to say what kind of blue. So I said, all right. You know the blue on a lizard's belly? That sudden kind of blue you see for a second sometimes? So blue that afterwards you always think you made it up. Sure, she said, I know that kind of blue. Then she told me hers, and it was brown. Maybe I looked surprised because she said, not many people appreciate brown, but I don't care. I do. And the one I like best is a dark reddish brown that's good for mountains and for rocks. You see it in steep cliffs a lot. I said, I know that kind of brown. Then it was my turn to ask, so I said, what is your favorite thing to touch? She said, my feet like mud, but my face likes wind, especially if I'm running up a hill. So I have to choose both things. I said, wait, it isn't fair to choose two favorite things. It is when you have to, she said. Any other way to play, it would be silly. I could see that she was right. I said, my favorite thing to touch was kitten fur, but then I changed my mind and wanted clear creek water. And then I changed it again, and that time I was sure my favorite thing was sand. Clean, dry, powdery desert sand. She didn't like it that I changed my mind, but all she said was, it makes the game go better if you've already thought of your favorite things before you play. I said I would next time. Then we chose our favorite sounds. She said hers was bees, but not just one or two. She said it takes about 1,000 bees buzzing in all the fields around to make the kind of loud bee sound she likes. For mine, I chose a bird I'd heard one morning in the mountains of New Mexico and never saw and never heard again and couldn't even say why I still remember it. She said that it was all right that I didn't know its name. So we went on to, what's your favorite place to live? She said her favorite place to live was in a tree. I said, doesn't it have to be someplace you've really lived? She said, that's right, it does. And I've lived in lots of trees. She didn't say how long she'd lived in any tree, and I didn't ask. I said, I knew my favorite place to live, but I wasn't sure it was fair to say because I hadn't really lived there yet, even though I planned to. She said the rule is that it's okay if you're pretty sure you're going to live there someday. So I said, I am. It's in a cave with foxes. That's fair, she said. I think a tree is best for summer, but a cave would be all right for winter nights. We must have named 100 favorite things that afternoon. I remember that her favorite dream is flying. She said, it is so easy in that dream, looking down on little hills and valleys, flapping her arms when she wants to go higher. She said she dreamed it 7 times. Mine is finding turquoise beads when I'm walking along. Not really looking, not trying to find them. I dreamed it once about a year ago. Her favorite thing to see moving is fish underwater. Mine is falling stars. Her favorite thing to taste is snow and honey mixed. A little more honey than snow. Mine is bread just baked at home, still warm. Her favorite smell is the alfalfa growing in this field. Mine is a desert rain, not rain anywhere else. Her favorite shape is zigzag. Mine is round. Finally, I said, what is your favorite time of day? And she said, now, just about now, when I've been running in the field and getting out of breath and falling down and watching ladybugs and finding someone to play the tell what your favorite thing is game and playing it, and then maybe walking back as far as the road together. I was going to say that sunrise is my favorite time of day, but when I thought about it, I wanted to choose now, too. I wasn't sure she would let us choose the same thing, but she was nice about it. She said, we can. That's my favorite way to end the game. By then, it was getting late, so we walked back as far as the road together. The end.
Today is our 10th annual observance of what I have sometimes called Adoration Sunday. It is our way of celebrating the pagan holiday of, it's spelled like it's pronounced Beltane, but in the Celtic language it's pronounced Bealtaine. So Bealtaine is also called May Day. It is the cross-quarter day between spring equinox in March and summer solstice in June. So it's observed around May 1st, that's when we're used to thinking of May Day, but the precise midpoint will be this coming Saturday morning. Bealtaine is a time of celebration. In the timeless story of the pagan wheel of the year, the sun god, who died at Samhain in October and was then reborn in December at Yule, the sun god is getting older and growing stronger. We see that each day as our days grow longer. Spring is well underway and new life abounds. Bealtaine is often celebrated with a great bonfire. You're likely familiar with the practice of dancing around the maypole. Everything is blooming. Life and beauty abounds. This is, therefore, an appropriate time of year for us to celebrate what is good in the world with expressions of joy and beauty and love. Such celebrations are even more important when we are living in tumultuous times, as we have been and as we will continue to be. In tumultuous times like these, things like joy, laughter, time with friends and families. These things aren't just a break from everyday life. They are important strategies for sustaining ourselves, for keeping ourselves going. We need joy, laughter, time outdoors, and time with friends and family. So how can we cultivate these experiences in our lives? Especially when we may be feeling down and overwhelmed. How can we invite joy and wonder into our lives? There are two practices to cultivate, I think, presence and gratitude. Those of us who are adults must be on the lookout for opportunities to experience joy. Yes, it's adults who struggle with presence and being fully present to the moment. We can learn from our younger congregants how to be fully present to what's happening. That disconnection is the danger of being too connected to a phone or your book or your newspaper or your television. We need to make time to look up from our distractions. Look up and see the world happening around us. We can't appreciate what we don't notice. It might be as simple as going for a walk. It may be as complex as inviting some people over. And then when we do these things, we need to be intentional and try to be fully present to what is happening. Listening to the leaves rustling in the trees, listening when people talk, giving our full attention. Will you take a breath with me now? Feel the chair, or for you at home, the couch, under your legs. Feel your clothes against your skin. Feel your breath coming in and going out. It is okay that we don't live fully present all of the time. Some of you Buddhists may be working on more than that, but the rest of us have more moderate goals. But we must, therefore, recognize those special times when being fully present is a gift we give ourselves. For me, the Chalice Courtyard on Sunday after worship is one place and time that I try to be fully present to what is happening around me, who I am seeing, the sound of people talking together, the laughter of the children, the air on my skin, the sun shining, even if it's not always shining as brightly as it might, presence. So now I'd like to invite Kathleen Swift forward to talk to us a little bit about something happening on our courtyard after service today.
Hello. So next Sunday, the children in the third through fifth grade class are going to be exploring the concept of making a difference. So we all know about Swedish activist Greta Thunberg, whose story is powerful and inspiring. But we're going to talk about the little things that we can all do that change the world, like paying it forward at a Starbucks, or, you know, going up to a newcomer on the courtyard, or maybe just smiling at a store clerk. Judy's really good at that, by the way. She'll just be talking to somebody about a transaction, they'll just say, how's your day going? And their face changes. It's just, she noticed them. I mean, I've heard her do it on the phone talking to insurance people. I was listening to a podcast of Hidden Brain about kindness. And the researcher was explaining that, you know, when you do something for someone, a kindness happens. You know, when you do a kindness, you feel good. And the person who receives the kindness, they feel good, not only about the kindness, but even beyond that, it's that someone took the trouble to help them or do something for them. I'm sure you've noticed that. And there's lots of ways we can make small positive changes. But I'd like you to think of a way that you have done something small that made a difference. I'm gonna have this banner on the courtyard. So if you could just, you know, write a little, just a little sentence about what you've done to make a difference, then we're gonna use this in our class next week. So thank you.
So remember that for after the service. So I was just talking about presence. The second practice is gratitude. So gratitude isn't an emotion. It doesn't rise up and wash over us. Gratitude is a practice and a choice. Gratitude practice is a proven method of improving mood and lifting spirits. When I'm feeling grouchy, I try to think of five things that I'm grateful for. It can feel hard to get started because when I'm grouchy, it seems like everything is terrible. But once I can think of the first one and then the second one, by the third or fourth gratitude, I can feel the lightning of whatever it was that was weighing me down. In joyful moments, of course, we don't have to work so hard. In fact, when we become fully present to what is happening around us, we will often find that gratitude flows easily then. We're grateful to be here together. Grateful to be online together. Grateful to be connected to our community on Sunday mornings. Grateful for the sound of the children in the chapel. Grateful for everyone who helps make worship happen. Grateful for the music and the story and singing together. Once we get going, it's easy. Our hearts open and flood with recognition for what is good in our lives. Today is a reminder to take time to celebrate all that is beautiful and wonderful in being alive. We come together in praise, in joy, and in love. We come together to let ourselves love exuberantly and unabashedly, and to feel ourselves a part of the interconnected web of all existence. And of course, there will be those among us who do not feel the joy and wonder of being alive today. That is okay. We all carry at times grief and anger, confusion and fear. Of course we do. And what helps us overcome our grief, our anger, confusion, and fear, what keeps us going, is love. That's what we're celebrating today. So you are invited to express some of your gratitude, your joy, as part of our service this morning. As always, you can participate or not as you choose. It's up to you. For those of you here in the chapel, we have heart-shaped post-it notes. They've been distributed to some of you already, but we'll get them distributed more widely, where you can write or draw what brings you joy. People, places, food, TV shows, all your favorite things. We have plenty of post-it notes, so don't be shy about using multiple notes. And then we'll collect your post-it notes for display up front. I have a board we can put them on, or as you can see, you can also just start to put them around the walls as you choose. For our congregants online, you can type in the chat all of the different kinds of things that bring you joy. People, places, food, books, TV shows, all your favorite things. Then after that time, there will also be a time here in the chapel for you to come up to the microphone to say out loud some of the things that bring you joy. Naming our joys, naming our gratitudes, this is an important practice. This is how we lift not only ourselves up, but each other. So let's have time to hear about each other's joys. And then I will let you know when we're going to shift from writing on our post-it notes to speaking at the microphone. So right now, you're invited to write your joys and gratitudes on paper or in the chat. We have crayons and colored pens, and we'll have some music while we do this.
Thank you. on our post-it notes there, filling up the board. Is this okay? So now you're invited to come forward and speak some of these joys out loud. And again, you may feel like, but I just wrote them down. I encourage you to come up anyway, because we'll have time after the service to read what people wrote, but we can also hear from each other some of our things. So what brings me joy, what I'm grateful for, all my nieces and nephews and grandnieces and grandnephews, and avocado, and the lake and the pond near my house, and of course my little kitty Sophie. You're invited forward. And if for our young, we can adjust the microphone height for our younger people.
Well, I have more than this, but I wrote down Judy, the sunrise, Tim's music, and another thing. I can't remember.
I wrote down a few things too, among them spring flowers and the pond in my backyard. The company of friends and chalice.
I wrote down my joy so I won't forget. Joy is reading the comics in the Sunday paper. Joy is the bird coming to drink in the pool in the early morning. Joy is the old movie I've seen a dozen times. Joy is seeing the smile in a friend in their chalice courtyard.
Well, what brings me joy is Peyton Joy, and she turned 3 yesterday. What brings you joy? Oh, and California poppies.
What brings me joy is coffee, my bird feeder, and sometimes when I say I love you to Ryder, he closes his eyes and he goes, thanks.
One thing that brings me joy is smiling in love.
That's what brings me joy. What brings me joy are kittens and tacos.
I remembered. It's kids.
Right now, the way my jacket feels against my skin.
What brings me joy is finding things out and discovering new things.
I almost didn't speak my joy because I want to save it for the second service, but I'm going to anyway. My kids, Rowan and Declan, my wonderful partner, Tammy, music for sure, a cabin in the woods, and pickleball.
I was overwhelmed by Cyrus. Thanks, Cyrus. What brings me joy is working from home,
working from home, and then bringing my son's laptop to Hawaii and working from home while I'm on a house sitting slash vacation for so long. And teaching RE really, really brings me joy.
What brings me joy is also bees and butterflies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. All right, thank you for sharing your joys. Now let's sing about our joys.
Please rise in body or spirit to join in singing. We're going to do this one a cappella. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Down in my heart.
Down in my heart. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Down in my heart to stay.
And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Chalice in my heart.
And I'm so happy, so very happy.
I've got the love of Chalice in my heart. I've got the love, 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 love down in my heart.
Down in my heart.
Down in my heart, I've got the love, 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 love down in my heart.
Down in my heart to stay.
And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Chalice in my heart.
And I'm so happy, so very happy.
I've got the love of Chalice in my heart.
4 or 5.
I've got the wonder, 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 wonder down in my heart.
Down in my heart.
Down in my heart.
I've got the wonder, 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 wonder down in my heart.
Down in my heart to stay.
And I'm so happy, so very happy.
I've got the love of Chalice in my heart.
And I'm so happy, so very happy.
I've got the love of Chalice in my heart.
I've got the far out faith that picks up farmers down in my heart.
Down in my heart.
Down in my heart.
I've got the far out faith that picks up farmers down in my heart.
Down in my heart to stay.
And I'm so happy, so very happy.
I've got the love of Chalice in my heart.
And I'm so happy, so very happy.
I've got the love of Chalice in my heart.
I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Down in my heart,
down in my heart.
I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Down in my heart to stay.
And I'm so happy, so very happy.
I've got the love of Chalice in my heart.
And I'm so happy, so very happy.
I've got the love of Chalice in my heart.
The Sunday offering is an expression of the generosity that makes our congregational life possible. Lao Tzu teaches in the Tao Te Ching, the master has no possessions. The more he does for others, the happier he is. The more she gives to others, the wealthier she is. Please text your donation to Chalice. If you haven't texted a donation before, know that once you text the amount, you'll get a reply with a link to enter your credit card information. If you have already entered this information previously when you've donated, you won't need to enter it again. If your Sunday donation is meant to be part of your pledge payment, please be sure to indicate pledge after the dollar amount. The phone number for text donations will be on screen in a moment. If you prefer to make an in-person donation of cash or check, there are envelopes and a donation box to the left of the chapel door. You can leave these donations after the services. Please give generously. Offering with words of affirmation. We give to the work of Chalice Congregation. Our work weaves the fabric of love called community. To this end, we dedicate ourselves and this our offering.
joys and gratitudes always in your heart.
May they strengthen you when you need strengthening. May they lighten you when you need lightening. May they comfort you when you need comforting. And may we find ways to take the many blessings and joys of our community back out into the world to all who we encounter. May it be so. Blessed be, you are invited to rise in body or spirit to join again in singing.
We give thanks for this precious day, for all gathered here and those far away, for this time we share with love and care. Oh, we give thanks for this precious day. Oh, we give thanks for this precious day. For all gathered here and those far away, for this time we share with love and care. Oh, we give thanks for this precious day.
Our closing words come from Cynthia Landrum. We leave this gathered community, but we don't leave our connection. Our concerns, our care for each other, our service to each other, to the world, and to our faith continues. Until we are together again, friends, be strong, be well, be true, be loving. Love and blessings to each of you. Blessed be. You are invited to close our time together by singing The Well. After our closing hymn, you may begin social hour on the patio and also online. You just stay in the Zoom room and it will begin.
We drink from the well together. Cool, cool water that quenches my thirst. A thirst for justice, a thirst for joy, a thirst for a love that we're all a part of. We drink from the well. We drink from the well together. Hand in hand we are standing as one. Standing for justice, standing for joy, stand for a love that we're all a part of. We drink from the well. Open the doors to the world outside, spirits renewed from within. Look for the dream in each other's eyes, the spark where a new world begins. Yes, we drink from the well together. Heart to heart we are dancing as one. Dancing for justice, dancing for joy. Dance for a love that we're all a part of. Drink from the well, spirits renewed. We drink from the well, stand hand in hand. We drink from the well, dancing for joy. I feel my heart swell. We drink from the well.
An announcement. I'm sorry.
Just one. I'm sorry.
I apologize.
No, don't worry about it. It's all good.
It's Board President Tom, you get up here. We want to update you guys on the latest for the pledge drive. Yay! So, we are thrilled to stand before you to celebrate a really amazing achievement that we are within 94% of the fundraising goal of $340,000,
yeah,
which is really awesome. I was very optimistic in my ability to get here and color the pledge-o-meter this morning, which did not happen, but it will happen for second service. Today we are at $319,439 and 102 pledges. The goal was 110, so really amazing. Some great stats for you is that over 75% of our pledgers are either first-time pledgers, returning pledgers, or people who heard the messages and decided to increase their pledges, which is really amazing. Did you want to read? Okay. This accomplishment is a testament to the hard work, dedication, and generosity to each and every one of you. And although we didn't get to 100% of our goal, I can confirm that we can continue to receive ministry from our beloved Reverend Sharon. So, which we heard time and time again was the wish for so many of us, and the board will continue to be in touch about next year's budget in the coming months. We want to express our sincere gratitude to each and every one of you for your support, hard work, dedication. You have truly made a difference, and we are honored to serve alongside of you. Thank you for being part of this incredible journey and for your continued commitment to Chalice, our spiritual home. Together, we can accomplish great things, and I look forward to seeing what we can achieve in the future. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.